All right, ladies and gentlemen, I think we're going to do this. If I can ask everybody to please take your seat at one of the benches, sit anywhere you like, get comfortable. If you want to stand, you can stand as well. This night is all about you, so whatever you guys want to do. Keep drinking beer, though. That's a definite must. My name is Rick Campanelli. Very excited to be here with you this evening. Very honored to be here with you this evening. I'll cheers to that. All right, so welcome one and all to the Canadian Brewers Choice Awards presentation and industry holiday party. How's everyone doing this evening? Pretty good? Right on. Now this event, you may or may not know, is being live streamed as well, okay? On Brewers Journal Canada YouTube channel and on the Instagram page, so we can say hello to everyone watching at home or wherever you may be digitally. The team from Brewers Journal Canada is proud to announce the inaugural year of the Canadian Brewers Choice Awards, which is designed to recognize the very best in Canadian brewing. I've done a bunch of these awards, but I've never done like a beer awards. I love this. This is amazing. An honor to be here, guys. Thanks for having me. We want to put the best of the best in the spotlight this evening. And if I'm too loud, just tell me. I'll back off the mic. The Brewers' Choice Awards will be split into 8 categories. We've got Young Brewer of the Year. We've got Brewer of the Year. The New Brewery of the Year. Brewery of the Year. There's going to be a quiz on this in a little while, too, so take notes. New Beer of the Year. Beer of the Year. Branding of the Year. And Lifetime Achievement Award recipient of the year / lifetime. There's a wealth of incredible beer being produced in Canada, as we all know. The best beers deliver fantastic flavor and awe-inspiring aroma, appear dazzling, soothing, or refreshing to the eye, are consistent, and leave a lasting impression, whether it's a one-off brew or a year-round number that offers up that sought-after reliability. Now, these beers are being produced by brilliant breweries of all shapes and sizes, some new, some not so new. Many are made up of only small teams. I met Kent and Steve earlier. I think when I speak of small teams, you guys can relate. Many are made up of employees, a ton of employees, dozen employees. But often there is one individual guiding the way, establishing the path forward, setting the example. Usually that brewer is a seasoned vet of the process. On the other hand, the industry has welcomed new and fresh faces into its brew houses and cellars across Canada. These rookies frequently take on immense challenges. We will celebrate all these elements tonight. We're going to name some judges and give out some thank yous. Please talk if you'd like. I've done Italian weddings before. I'm good to go. I can push through just about anything. I'm serious. Don't quiet down on my account. Let's introduce you to the judges. First, we start with Tim Sheehan. Tim, I don't know if you're with us. I've been given a script and your name is on it. But if you're here, give me a wave. Is Tim here? He's in England right now. Okay. Couldn't make the trip over. Didn't want to pay that PCR test fee. Tim is the launch editor of the Brewers Journal in the UK. Since co-founding the bi-monthly in September 2014, the magazine has gone from strength to strength, increasing to monthly output by September 2017. Sheehan is also the editor of Brewers Journal Canada since its launch in Canada in 2016. And apparently Tim is in England tonight. But probably watching us on the live stream. How you doing, Tim? Nice to see you, my man. All right, we continue on with other judges. The Brewers Journal Canada team and fellow associates. The team behind Brewers Journal Canada has experienced firsthand the tremendous growth in Canadian craft breweries since the launch of its first magazine issue in the summer of 2016. Congratulations to you guys. That was like over 5 years ago. Well done. Its quarterly publication is designed to give breweries, distributors, and suppliers an essential insight into the issues that matter to them and how to take advantage of this growing market. The team also hosts the Brewers Lectures Canada Events Series. That one rings a bell. As well as the Brewers Choice Awards. We also have Patty Finnegan. Patty has been servicing the brewing segment with process solutions for over 20 years and is a Prud'homme Level 3 beer sommelier as well as a certified BJCP. Patty in the house? Patty in the house? What up, Patty? Well done, Patty. He's also an active judge on both the local and national scene. He's also a published brewing equipment technology reviewer slash writer, as you may have come across in the Brewer's Journal, and an avid home brewer and home brewing consumer, I'm assuming. Well done, Patty. Thanks for being with us, and thanks for your judging skills. We're also going to thank each supporting partner of all 8 award categories, including Genray Limited, Charles Ferrum, Carefoot Beverage Solutions, Brew Ninja, Summit Labels, Top 5 Solutions, and BSG Craft. We would also like to sincerely thank our trophy partner, Econs, and our dinner partner, North Keg. Speaking of dinner, you guys hungry? The beer appetite just wasn't enough, right? We need our food. The dinner will start momentarily before we go into our shortlist for each category as well as announcing the winners. We have a special buffet menu tonight. All the items have been infused with a variety of Brunswick Bierworks beers and created by the queen of intoxicating recipes, Lori Harris from Allsauced. Yeah. Allsauced is a unique business that supports companies looking to broaden their consumer base. They strive to show new ways alcohol can be enjoyed. There are multiple ways, yes, this is true, while promoting business-to-business support and relationships. Now, the focus is on food, cocktails, beer, or just good food and boozy combos. Lori focuses on their marriage, or really, their flings together. Lori is also the designer of Forkuality, a movement with two goals. One, to promote the right to food for all people, and two, to respect food choices as related to vegan, vegetarian, pescatarian, or none of the above. This evening, we will eat together. That's pretty fun. Like, is this a dream or what, people? We're gathered together. We're gonna drink together and feast together. Thank the Lord above. Okay, let's do it. I invite you all now to the buffet area, which is set up just behind the bar over here. We're going to give you guys some time to fill your plates, get back to your seats, and then we're going to continue with the awards ceremony. All right. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you back here in 10 to 15 minutes. Loving you, weather.
That's right. Keep the fantasy hot like fire. Jump, 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 jump. Let me see you do the stomp. Girls, let me see you shake your rump. Yeah. Your brothers, get it from the back and pump it. Let's do it, do it, do it. I'm a little bit country. I'm a little bit rocky. I don't sew to sew. Big letters all big and bold. Old dirty bass, dirty bass will blow.
Do a remix. dogs cry out in the night as they grow restless, longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right, sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus above the Serengeti. I seek to cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become.
I guess the take my wallet if you want it now. Jump in the Cadillac, girl, let's put some miles on it. Anything you want, just to put a smile on it. You deserve it, baby, you deserve it all. And I'm gonna give it to you. Gold jewelry shining so bright. Strawberry champagne on ice. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Sex by the fire at night. Silk sheets and diamonds all white. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. I'm talking trips to Puerto Rico. Say the word and we go. You can be my flica. Girl, I'll be a flico mama's sister. I would never make a promise that I can't. I promise that your smile ain't gonna never leave. Sharpest breeze in Paris, every day 24 carats. Take a look in that mirror. Now tell me who's the fairest. Is it you?
Is it you?
Is it me?
Is it me?
Say it's us.
Say it's us.
And I'll agree, baby. Jump in the Cadillac, girl, let's put some miles on it. Anything you want, just to put a smile on it. You deserve it, baby, you deserve it all. For you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Sex by the fire at night. Silk sheets and diamonds all white. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. You say you want a good time, but here I am, baby. Here I am. Say what's on your mind. What's on your mind? If you wanna
coming for leaving a trace. I'm not one guy to give and raise it, because my life is 10 shades of gray. I pray all 10 fade away, sell the praise and for the 7 days. And like his promise is true, only my faith can undo the many chances I believe would bring my life to an end. Clear blue and unconditional skies have dried the tears from my eyes. No more lonely cries. My
Jimmy Suave, thank you very much. He's spinning your music tonight. Make some noise for Jimmy over there, the DJ. Great stuff, man. Loving the John Mayer. And I got to apologize. How's the food tasting, by the way? Delicious. It smells good. I haven't been able to eat anything yet, but it smells so good. It's part two to revealing who the judges are. So you see, I missed a page earlier. So to Ren and Roger, I apologize. And let's get down to talking about the last two judges for the evening. Ren Navarro. Ren, with nearly a decade of experience in the alcohol industry, And since launching Beer Diversity in 2018, Ren has become a known name at breweries, wineries, distilleries, and beyond. She has given talks on diversity and inclusion at several colleges and countless festivals, panels, radio shows, podcasts throughout North America. In addition to being a diversity educator, Ren is a craft beer consultant for bars and restaurants in Ontario and an educator for countless businesses throughout the country. Beer Diversity is more than just a company that educates. It's a resource built from the passion and love of the industry to do better and be better. But you all knew that, right, about Ren? Ren, thank you very much for being on the judging panel. I know you had some pretty tough decisions to make, and we appreciate that. And lastly, how could I forget Roger? Roger was one of the first people I met when I walked in here. Roger, please forgive me. But Roger, you're part of the sequel tonight regarding the judges. Roger Mittag is the founder of Canada's leading beer education company, Thirst for Knowledge, Inc. As one of the leading beer experts in Canada, he has delivered quality beer education since 1997 and is a consultant slash educator to many breweries and restaurant groups, bringing his extensive beer industry knowledge and enthusiastic approach to their businesses. In 2009, Roger created Prudhomme Beer Certification, a beer sommelier program, the first comprehensive online beer education program in the world? Woo! Roger. Well done, man. Roger is also a published author who contributes to magazines and books and has appeared on radio and television sharing his love of beer. Roger, thank you very much for being on the judging panel this evening. Wow, we got some pretty high-class judges in the house tonight. All right, everyone, continue to eat. If you need seconds, Lori guarantees that there's more food to be eaten all night long. So if you need seconds, go down there. I'm not going to stop doing what I'm doing. I'm going to keep talking, but if you need to feed yourselves, just go down and get more. We now start with perhaps the most exciting part of the evening, announcing our short list and naming the final winner of each category. Basically, the moment we've all been waiting for, as they say. Category number one, Young Brewer of the Year, presented by Top 5 Solutions. And before we announce the shortlist, a message from its supporting partner. Take a look at the screen. Can you all read lips? I think he's saying, don't get too drunk tonight, okay? Have a good time, drink beer. We're gonna try to get audio for this. A little louder, sir. Shall we try again or should I go on, Richard? It's up. Oh. Come on up. I thought you looked familiar.
Hey. Rick, take it. I know your sister actually.
Yeah, it's like a family connection. So I'm at a wedding once, right? All I was saying was that I'm Steve Grundy, founder and president of Top 5 Solutions. We're a company in Hamilton, Ontario, and we provide equipment to the industry. We do process and packaging equipment, and we represent high quality brands from Germany, from France, from the United States, and from Canada. And so, in fact, I supplied a lot of the stainless that's in this building. But I want to say thank you to the Brewers Journal. We really appreciate being involved in all these events. I think this is like the second or third that we've done. And we're particularly proud to sponsor the Young Brewer Award because, as we all know, young brewers are the future of the industry. And it's super important to celebrate their success. And we're super proud to do that. So without further ado, we'll turn it back over to the MC. And thank you very much.
Well done, Steve. Thanks very much. All right, so let's get to the nominees for Young Brewer of the Year. And they are Artur Merkulov from Polar Park Brewing. Yeah, give it up. Brendan D. McDonald from Stack Brewing. And Kelsey DeNoyer from Flux Brewing. And the winner is, well done, Kelsey. Yes, from Flux Brewing. You just won the Young Brewer of the Year. Kelsey, come on up here.
Listen to the first verse.
Watch out now.
I'd just like to say thank you to the beer gods.
Well done, Kelsey. Moving on to the Brewer of the Year, presented by Brew Ninja. And again, before we announce the shortlist, let's do it. What the heck? A message from its supporting, hold on. Hold on for that little game. We're not taking any more chances. With the videos, we're holding on a second. Kelsey, I wish your speech was longer, because now I gotta. Well, only if you want. You forgot to thank somebody, right? It happens. Come.
The floor is yours. How much time do I have to take up? How much time do we have to? 5 whole minutes. Hi, everybody. My name is Kelsey. I'm the brewer at Flux. I guess, I didn't really think this was kind of a thank you speech kind of thing, so I didn't really prepare anything. But I guess I'd like to thank Flux for hiring me. Putting me in the position to win Young Brewer of the Year. I'd like to thank my age for making it into the Young Brewer category. I just made the cut, 31. Just made the cut. Actually, I guess since I'm up here and giving thanks to people, there's probably one person that I'd actually would like to thank. 31, it kind of took me a bit of a while to get my life in order, get my career in order, and figure out what the hell I wanted to do. And the whole time I was doing it and kind of struggling, my wife stood by me, and she supported me through school and through all the low times, and she's here with me tonight. And so I'd for sure, she's my number one supporter, and you're the reason why I got to where I am today, so that's about it. Is that enough time? Yeah, we good? We're good, everybody, yeah!
See, Kelsey, if you don't come up here and thank the spouse, then you're not. Someone's gonna be mad tonight. She's the DD tonight too, as well. Okay, well done, well done. Congratulations, Rich. You want to say a few words? We're gonna keep going, and in the future, if you can keep your acceptance speech a little shorter, it's all good. I'm just joking. It was wonderful. Category number two, Brewer of the Year. We're gonna move right along, and I'm gonna name the nominees for you this evening for Brewer of the Year. Now we have it. Okay, it's a live show, and this is how it works. Let's hear from the sponsor, which are Brew Ninja, all the way from Regina, is that correct? Hello, Regina. Have I had that much beer already? Okay, who is that guy? Was that Charles? Or is that from Brew Ninja? That's Brew Ninja, head brewmaster, right? Okay, but Brew Ninja still. Okay, let's move on. Brewer of the Year, are you excited or what? Let's do it. Here's the short list. Jeff Broders from Indy Ale House. Jeff? Mary Beth Keith from Granite Brewing. Mary Beth Keith, well done. Is that you right there, Mary? Yeah, there you are. The serious one at the table. Okay. Mike Lackey and team from Great Lakes Brewery. Mike? Oh my gosh, the winner's Mary. Mary, well done. Yes, Mary.
Yes. Take a look over here, baby. What you see?
You know you're looking at a window.
Yeah. Jay Fox.
Those guys are fucking amazing, so I'm completely surprised. Thank you, judges. Thank you, my team. I wouldn't be anything without you guys. I'm getting emotional. That's me. Hi. Your speech was amazing and very funny. I wish that I could follow that up. But anyway, thanks to my parents, because they've always encouraged me to do this. My dad was the brewer before me, and I followed in his footsteps. And, thanks everyone who's ever bought our beer and loved it and gotten me to where I am today. So thank you. This is amazing.
Yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
You know you're looking at a window.
Yeah. Jay Fox. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Let me get it right here.
JT, so you. Let's go.
Happy belated birthday, Mary? Roger, yeah? A few days ago, or? Well, Bess. Well done. Excellent, excellent. Brewer of the Year. It's huge. That's right. Give her a kiss. All right. That's your... You thanked your husband, right? Yes, you did. New Brewery of the Year, presented by Charles Farum. Here are your nominees. Flux Brewing, Rough Waters Brewing, and Rally Brewing. Right? There they are. We're not even going to go to a video for this one. I'm just going to tell you right now, congratulations to Flux Brewing. You are the new brewery of the year, Flux Brewing.
Five-minute speech and just say thanks, everybody, and shout out to Jeremy and Braden, our co-owners that couldn't be here tonight, and we're here to represent for them. We've been there from the start, and we're super proud of what we got going on at Flux, and we're stoked to be here tonight. So thanks, everybody. This is awesome.
Amazing. Well done, Flux Brewery. Brewery of the Year, presented by Gen Ray Limited. And before we announce the shortlist, a video right up here from its supporting partner. All right, and the nominees shortlisted for Brewery of the Year are Blind Man Brewing, Great Lakes Brewery, and Wellington Brewery. That wasn't a burp, was it? Okay. Those similar sounds, those two. Congratulations, Wellington Brewery. You are the Brewery of the Year for 2021.
I guess we're going to say a few words here. As we've been around for a very long time, we've had a very long and sordid past. And in the last, I'd say probably 5 or so years, we've been working really hard to stay relevant with all you new little motherfuckers. And that's not been easy. And thank you for all of the inspiration that you've given us to stay relevant when we are a pretty old brewery and we brew a lot of classic English style beers. I just want to extend my thanks to the whole craft beer, Ontario craft beer specifically, industry that's been working hard to create a lot of equality in all of our breweries, a really welcoming space for everybody, and just putting our values not only on quality beer, but creating a quality community for people to feel welcome in. So thank you to all of you as well.
Well done, Wellington Brewery. And I guess that's a good thing in your business to have younger breweries and not so young breweries, because it's not like you guys are athletes. And, you know, when you're an athlete and you hit that moment where it's time to retire, you can't perform anymore. But that's not the case when it comes to breweries, right? You both look at each other. The older one's looking at the younger ones. The younger ones looking at the, it's a beautiful thing. It's in a beautiful family as well. So congratulations to Wellington Breweries, again, for Brewery of the Year. Moving right along to Branding of the Year. And Branding of the Year is presented by Summit Labels. And before we announce the shortlist, a video from its supporting partner right now. All right, that's one badass can right there. Is that thing on the market? I'm a sucker for branding and marketing, can I just add. Are you as well? Loving the packaging, the marketing, the colors, whatever you guys are doing these days, just loving it. Here are the nominees, shortlisted for Branding of the Year. Establishment Brewery, Little Beasts Brewing, Polar Park Brewing Co., Tin Whistle Brewery. You're all in the house, right? And the winner is Polar Park Brewing Co.
Can't touch this.
Well done. Yeah.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this.
Hey, oh my goodness, sorry, I didn't expect anything like this tonight, but thanks, Phil, if you're watching us. Phil is our business partner, and I promised him if he, you know, he couldn't make it here, so Phil, you're with us in spirit. And also Rob told me to pretend that I don't speak any English, so he can do all the talking. Okay, so I think I'm gonna do exactly what he said. Yeah, Rob, it's all yours.
There we go. This was a surprise. Artur told me I have to get to Toronto for 6:30 tomorrow, and that was yesterday. You didn't tell me any of this. He is from Siberia, or north of Siberia. He's our brewer. He fixed all my issues. So this is Polar Park Brewing, Edmonton, Alberta. If you haven't heard about us, we bred polar bears for about 50 years, and now we brew beer. So that's all I want to say. From bears to beers, thank you.
Was that guy shitting us? True story? I'm new to this, huh? Congratulations, guys. Well done. On to new beer of the year, presented by Carefoot Beverage Solutions. Your nominees are Carbon Brewing Co., Helios, PEI Brewing, West Coast IPA, and Imperial City Brewing, Chocolate Milk Peanut Butter. And the winner is Carbon Brewing Co., Helios. Congratulations, guys.
I'm jumping out of Bentley, yeah. And I say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had a dedication. People hating, say we changing, we made.
So our brewmaster's actually back home in Venezuela right now. His name is Bernardo. This is his award. We did none of the work for this. Thank you for the Brewers Journal to, you know, host these events. It's a great experience for us as a new brewery. To be part of this awesome community. I mean, I know Wellington just shouted out to some of the new breweries. We want to shout out to some of the older breweries as well. To Rick, you know, for being part of my much music childhood. If you don't know who we are trying to fight climate change through beer. So we're trying to put sustainability first, and we look forward to doing that with all the amazing Ontario breweries here. So. Anybody who's interested in sustainability and climate change, well, let's have a beer and talk.
Well done, Carbon Brewing Co. Awesome stuff. Moving right along now to beer. There's only two more awards left. Whoa. Beer of the Year. This is a big one, folks. Presented once again by Carefoot Beverage Solutions. Your nominees are Faculty Brewing Hazy Pale Ale, Flora Hall IPA, and Blind Man Brewing Sour Cherry. Who do you think wins? Congratulations to Faculty Brewing, Hazy Pale Ale. You have just won Beer of the Year. Well done. Okay, yeah, Roger, you want to come up and say a few words? Come on up, Roger. Roger Mitzig, everybody.
I got told, suggested by Rich to come and accept this. So I'm going to accept it on behalf of faculty, whom I haven't met yet, but because they're named after a school and I run a beer school, that to me seems somewhat relevant. So congratulations to faculty. Thanks, Rick. That's all right. Thanks. I get to keep this, Rick?
Thanks, Roger, for accepting for faculty. Oh, I like this moment of the evening. Lifetime Achievement Award. Yeah. Presented by BSG Canada. Before I talk a bit about him, I'm just going to say who it is. The winner is Charles McLean. Charles, amazing stuff, Charles McLean. Don't come up yet, Charles McLean. Let's first close our eyes and imagine way back in the 1970s. Way back. Who was around then? Me too. Me too. A few of us. Charles McLean found himself in England in 1978 riding a Norton Commando bike on an adventure away from Ontario, where he called home. When he ran out of money, he ran out of gas as well. And to make a little cash, he was accepted at the local pub to tend the bar, and in turn was introduced to the craft of brewing beer. He was already very fond of beer, but this was a new angle. Now, eventually, Charles returned back home to Ontario to begin brewing his own ales at home, and he didn't stop there. Now, some will call Charles the godfather of Ontario craft brewing. Some of you in this room, perhaps. One of you. Roger. So we caught up with a few of the other godfathers and friends out there to see what they remember about Charles's journey and why he justifiably deserves this Lifetime Achievement Award this evening. He's one of the original lobbyists who helped pry away the provincial government's stranglehold on craft brewers, working with a British expatriate who started a Canadian branch of the group called the Campaign for Real Ale, or CAMRA. Now, together, they lobbied the provincial government to make it easier to set up a craft brewery, relaxing a number of laws, most importantly, to gain independent distribution. At that time, brewers had to buy into the beer store at a minimum 1% of their sales, according to the brewer's market share. Yes, booze all around. That was steep for craft breweries, as you know, and the flight eventually led to breweries able to deliver directly to pubs and restaurants. Thank God for Charles. Yeah, we have his efforts to thank for progressing microbrewing's chances to gain traction in the fight for market share. Now, in his early brewing days, Charles mashed in at the Spruce Goose in Toronto. I remember that place. A brewery set up in the old SCTV diner, working alongside Robert Huey, beer writer and photographer. Charles was one of the original partners slash brewers at Wellington Brewery that started back in 1985, you guys started? Wow, you are old. After a few years, he left Wellington to work as a consultant, and to name a few of the folks he teamed up with, he aided in the establishment of Seeps in London, Ontario. My wife went to Western, and she says amazing things about that place. She got really drunk in there. Whoa. Contributed to Bose in the early Church Key days, bringing in some equipment from Vermont, and also hooked up with Art Fab in London with Ivan Kovarik, where Kovarik was building nanosystems. Charles poured his heart and soul into F&M Brewery in Guelph as head brewmaster for 15 years, later to become Stonehammer, where the famous Stony D was born. Your neighbor? Okay. Charles... I love this evening. Everyone's just heckling and shouting. I just love this. Charles joined the Masters Brewers District, Ontario on April 1st, 1998. Is that an April Fool's joke, or is that true things happening right there? And has been a member since. Younger members back in the early 2000s have fond memories of sitting next to Charles at MBAA technical lectures when they were just starting their careers in brewing. He was eager to share his knowledge and support, and especially keen to get to the frigid, narrow lobby for the beer breaks, saving his chatter to go over the technical ideas and details just shared on the stage. People were always drawn to Charles. Famously, Charles built Guelph's Woolly Pub Bar and Cask Beer Engines, which recently had a fresh makeover in the summer of 2021. Charles's face is up on the wall, overseeing everything, as a needlepoint made by Hannah Sennett, joined later by George Ingelson's stare from across the room. Now today, Charles dedicates his time to McLean's Ales in Hanover, Ontario. As a pioneer, he continued to follow heart and taste buds. This eventually led to what has become his signature ale, the very same one that today bears his name. We're getting there. No, he's a Lifetime Achievement Award recipient. This all makes sense. In his spare time, Charles is a lifelong Gray County cottager, sharing the cottage with his sister Ruth, who famously runs a spinning wheel in that front room. Now, when Charles is not at the brewery or the cottage, he's doing carpentry in his shop, founding a woodworking group that has members who build canoes, are bowl turners and cabinetry makers, etc., etc. He's also an avid hunter, angler, and cross-country skier, and he loves a good barbecue. So, Lori, Alsace is definitely your lady, Charles. For the past decade or so, he opens his cottage for a brewer's weekend, a welcome respite for many, and hopefully resumes again very soon. In an interview with Barron magazine in 2017, Charles described himself as focused. When asked what his favorite tools were, such as his favorite app or program, he named hydrometers, thermometers, and pH meters as his essentials instead. Total brew geek right there. While focused, he describes his office as cluttered, yet he also is known as a brew house clean freak. So he's likely too busy cleaning the brewery to worry about his desk. Friends and colleagues describe Charles as remarkably chill. But don't let that fool you. He's a frantic SOB just like the rest of us. He's incredibly kind. Recipes pour from his head without a spreadsheet, and he has an incredible hustle. Charles, congratulations. You're an icon and a great friend to so many in this industry. Thank you for your contributions over the years and no doubt in the future to come. Make some noise for your Lifetime Achievement Award winner, Charles McLean.
It's a great honor to be given this award. And first of all, I want to thank all the brewers throughout my career and back in the early days when I didn't know that much, who really helped me. And I've always, you know, tried to pass on the knowledge I've gained to other younger brewers. And I've been teaching through CTS College on online brewing courses and enjoying that. And It's been a long ride. I started in 1979, and I've enjoyed the time, and I still enjoy making beer. I'm kind of winding down now. I've got a great packaging manager who's doing all the day-to-day stuff. I haven't had my rubber boots on in probably a year now. I'm focusing on the lab and planning for the future, and also you know, projects. We're just getting a new RO system in. We're starting to do some lagers, and we have 400 parts per million total hardness in our municipal water, so that's great for ales, but not very good for lager beers, so we're working on that. So we've got lots of projects and kind of winding down, still maybe next year I'll cut down to a few days a week at the brewery and spend more time in my woodworking shop, which I really like, and I also have so many projects there, and it was gratifying to see Wellington win tonight because I was the first brewer there, so that was very nice to see. So thank you all so much. And I appreciate it.
Yeah, make some noise for Charles, everybody. Excellent. Well done, Charles. Guys, what a night. It says wrap up. We're so stoked for 2022's event, with nomination submissions officially open at the end of March. Not tonight, end of March. And before we go, let's take some time to thank and rethank a few folks. Sponsors, we absolutely adore you. You are wonderful partners and a pleasure to work with. Please give them a cheers. Genray Limited, Charles Ferram, Carefoot Beverage Solutions, Brew Ninja, Summit Labels, BSG Craft, and Top 5 Solutions. Thank you so much. Econs, North Keg, and our long list of beer sponsors that you came across at your tables this evening. Without you guys, this night wouldn't be possible. And again, congratulations to the breweries and the brewers who jumped into the first edition of this event, bringing your beers to life in front of the panel with samples, stories, and evidence of your great passion for your craft. I've had a heck of a time. Thank you guys for having me, inviting me. That beer that I had earlier was delicious. Roger, great to meet you. Mark, nice to catch up with you. And Sarah, I met earlier. Patty's over here having a great old time. And an honor, guys, an absolute honor. I really mean that. And it's so good to get together after so long of being apart and in our own basements. Seeing each other virtually on a damn screen. God bless Brunswick Bierworks for bringing us together tonight and the Brewers Journal. Look at that. I just made that all up, and it's all right there. It's all right there. Lastly, to you guys, you folks right here, our guests, sharing a kickoff national event such as this with you is both cherished by the team and energizes us to continue making this yearly industry initiative bigger and better. Now it's time to enjoy the rest of our meals. Apparently, there's more food. Amazing. Additionally, let's keep drinking. What the heck? Although additional drink purchases can be made at the bar. No more freebies. Sorry, folks. The party will kick off shortly with DJ Jimmy Suave. Everybody, cheers. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful evening. Congratulations, everybody. It's all about us. You.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome, welcome, welcome. My name is DJ Jimmy Suave. I'm here for your entertainment purposes. If you guys have any requests, please feel free to come talk to me. I'll be more than happy to play your request.